With approximately 20 drugs approved over the last 20 years, the options for patients with myeloma continues to grow. One of these agents that we've had for a few years now is Selinexor, also known as Xpovio. It is the first in a new class of myeloma drugs called Xpo1 inhibitors, sometimes called selective inhibitors of nuclear export. We can consider Selinexor to now be the fourth major class of myeloma drugs after proteasome inhibitors, immunomodulatory agents, and monoclonal antibodies. It's very important that we develop new classes of drugs because these drugs provide unique ways of attacking myeloma. Often, we use the expression new mechanism of action to describe the different ways that we can treat myeloma. Selinexor presents a novel and significant mechanism of action in targeting myeloma cells for destruction. A hallmark of cancer cells is their ability to grow autonomously or by themselves, detached from the body's typical cellular coordination. They overcome the body's natural mechanism to prevent cancer growth. These natural prevention mechanisms are called tumor suppressors, or proteins inside the cells and often even in the nucleus. These tumor suppressors keep the cells in check. Well, cancer wants to get rid of these tumor suppressors. And there's a pathway or a doorway out of the nucleus called Xpo1. The good tumor suppressors can exit the nucleus through this pathway, leaving the cell at risk of becoming cancerous. In myeloma, we have learned that this Xpo1 pathway is overused, or as we call it, upregulated. This pathway forces tumor suppressors to leave the nucleus at a rapid rate. Selinexor, on the other hand, is an Xpo1 inhibitor and therefore blocks that pathway. Thereby, it keeps the good tumor suppressors in the nucleus and reduces the risk of the cell being cancerous. This means we have a new way to attack multiple myeloma. Selinexor was first introduced into myeloma through the STORM trial. It demonstrated that it can work even in the most heavily treated patients. These patients were penta-refractory, meaning their disease was resistant to five drugs, bortezomib or Velcade, carfilzomib or Kyprolis, lenalidomide or Revlimid, pomalidomide or Pomalyst, and daratumumab or Darzalex. In these patients, Selinexor by itself had a response rate of about 25%. As a result, it was approved in heavily relapsed myeloma to be given twice weekly with dexamethasone alone. Several studies have now been done with Selinexor earlier in the disease course of myeloma, as early as second line therapy. The phase 3 clinical trial Boston also showed that it can be used once weekly when combined with Velcade. Since then, Selinexor has been used in multiple clinical trials in combination with other myeloma drugs such as Velcade, Kyprolis, Pomalyst, and Darzalex, and as a result, it can be used in all of these combinations. Selinexor is a pill that is taken orally or by mouth. When first introduced, it caused a lot of GI side effects like nausea and anorexia, which is a lack of desire to eat. It also caused other effects such as low blood counts, a low sodium level, and fatigue. However, we have learned that if we give the drug once weekly and with the right supportive care like anti-nauseants, it is much better tolerated. We also use a much lower dose than was first introduced. Initially, we would give it a dose of 80 milligrams twice weekly, but now we typically give it between 40 to 80 milligrams once weekly. Please watch my other Myeloma Made Simple video called Selinexor Side Effect Management Made Simple to learn the details. So in summary, Selinexor is the first of a new class of drugs known as Xpo1 inhibitors that is highly effective in myeloma when given with dexamethasone alone or preferably in combination with other myeloma agents. It is much easier to take when given once weekly and at lower doses. Lastly, with the introduction of so many new T-cell therapies like CAR T-cell therapy and bispecific antibodies, we have also learned that Selinexor can be very effective before these therapies are given. This is because Selinexor does not impair the functioning of a patient's T-cells. It is great now to have another tool in our myeloma toolbox to treat patients.